You can see that tree kind of straight ahead. It's about, I don't know, maybe 40 feet tall or so. I have to get rid of it because if you look to the right, you'll see the greener tree. That's an oak tree. That one tree there that I want to take down is, it's a poplar and it's suffocating the oak tree off to the right. There's actually a bunch of poplars in there. I want to just rip them out. However, I think the only way from here, it looks like, that I can take that poplar down, I might have to pull it towards myself, which is not actually that safe, but I guess I'll grab the machine and we'll go down there and see what happens. Now, because these are way up on the hill, there's no real safe way of doing it. So, I can't get at them from the other side. Or from the top side, I can't get at them. That would be the safe way if I could. I'm just going to take them down. Now, the reason I'm using the machine is because I want to get as much of the roots out as possible. These poplar trees, the roots are just unbelievable. The trees will pop up everywhere where there's a root, and the roots spread out like spider webs, basically. I'm gonna try to approach it from a different angle and see what happens. Yeah, that's all it wanted. It wanted me to push it from a different angle. It's still got a few roots holding it, so I'll just yank it out of there and see, there's probably 100 more that are attached to the roots just from this one tree. In some spots you can see the roots, they're about as thick as the base of that tree is. it's almost wet enough here that pretty soon I can start burning big piles. So I'm going to put this machine up to one of the big piles that I cut previously a couple years ago. It's dry now. I'm going to start burning it. And once I get it burning, I'll be able to slowly add this wet crap on it and burn it as well. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to grab a handful of this stuff and bring it over towards where I'll, near the hot tub where I'm going to be burning it. Oh, that's way too big a handful. Okay, I don't want that much. Let's shake some of the dirt off of this one too. This actually works good for shaking the dirt off. I wouldn't have to shake the dirt off, but it's going into my burn barrel. Well, burning ring, we'll call it. My burning ring of fire. So I don't want to put dirt in my burning ring of fire. That wouldn't be good, would it? Okay, so I brought it nice and close to my fire pit, which is just right here. Now, I just need to make it into smaller pieces. I'm just going to use this little thing. Anybody that watches my channel knows that I got this given to me. It's one of those Chinese miniature chainsaws. It comes in handy quite often, and I've used it a lot, and I haven't had to sharpen it or anything yet, which is good. This one, they call it a Saker. Now, I could just do that about 100 more times, or I could put a match to the whole pile. It's just a little too early to do that still. I might have to wait till like the end of October before I can do that. But in the meanwhile, this works for whenever I want to have a fire. I'm not burning my good wood, I'm just burning garbage wood. I can still cook hot dogs on this. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm gonna take down a bunch more of those trees in my next video, most likely as well. Maybe some bigger ones.